Now, many of you have seen Shakespeare done very much like this. O Titus, bring your friend hither. But if any of you have seen Mr. Marlon Brando,
no, but Shakespeare can be different. France, Romans, countrymen. Let me rest.
You can also imagine maybe John Wayne is Macbeth going, well, is this a dagger I see before me?
Robin Williams was the type of performer that only comes around once in a lifetime. Originally finding fame through stand-up sets and the sitcom Mork and Mindy, he would eventually turn to Hollywood after his television breakthrough, a career shift that brought about some of his most memorable and iconic roles. Williams went on to call himself an Academy Award winner, earning 3 additional Oscar nominations during his time as an actor. That, along with multiple Golden Globes, Screen Actors Guild Awards, Emmys, and Grammys. He established himself as an unmatched performer with a style unique to himself, and acted as a signature to any production that he found himself joining in on, no matter the size of the role. Simply one of the funniest and most genuine actors ever to grace our screens, his influence can be felt in almost every corner of the entertainment landscape even 8 years after his tragic passing. So, in honor of his unrivaled legacy, here are our picks for Robin Williams' top 10 film performances.
Son of a bitch. He stole my life.
Number 10. Walter Finch, Insomnia. This oft-forgotten film from director Christopher Nolan pairs Robin Williams with Al Pacino for a murder mystery set against the freezing cold shores of a small Alaskan town. Williams plays the role of crime novelist and suspect Walter Finch, with Pacino as the troubled, sleep-deprived detective hot on his tail. The brooding suspense of the film is heightened with its setting of a town where the sun never sets, but it's Williams' atypically cold and calculated presence that really makes the film a nerve-wracking watch.
To them, I'm just a writer that Kay Connell admired. And Randy Stetz is the killer, and you're a hero cop. Your life's work is intact.
Williams steps away from his comedic nature for this psychological thriller that presents a stark look at police ethics in the modern era. Combining an innocent demeanor with malicious motives, Finch lures Pacino's detective Dormer into a series of sinister mind games and invites the audience to question whether or not he really is a murderer.
I saw. So what?
So you shoot your partner?
What results is a deadly confrontation in which both men find their stability on the brink of collapse. Insomnia asks for a different side of Williams, which he willingly delivers, and stands out in one of his most intriguing dramatic roles. Williams may have been known for making us laugh, but boy could he make us shiver too.
And then I'm really scared. I'm scared shitless. More scared than I've ever been before.
Number 9. Seymour Cy Parrish, One Hour Photo. Another deeply unsettling thriller, One Hour Photo allows Williams to demonstrate that as funny as he may be, he still has the ability to get under the audience's skin and make them squirm with discomfort. Playing completely against type, Williams is Cy, a socially inept photo technician at a retail store who becomes dangerously obsessed with a young couple and their child. Placing the family on a pedestal due to their seemingly idyllic lifestyle, his desire to get closer to them and achieve the same kind of existence leads him to take extreme measures, and alarming ones at that. With his compulsion amplified by his severe isolation, Cy's world slowly begins to fall apart after he uncovers a secret the family patriarch had been keeping from his wife. And with nothing to lose, his actions become all the more spine-tingling. This intense film once again allows Williams to sink into a darker, even more disturbed role, one that manages to go underrated despite the heavy amount of praise he received for it. One Hour Photo may not have been much of an awards darling, but it deserves credit for providing Williams the opportunity to show off his multifaceted abilities for a truly chilling hour and a half.
And if these pictures have anything important to say to future generations, it's this. I was here. I existed. I was young, I was happy, and someone cared enough about me in this world to take my picture.
Number 8. Perry, The Fisher King. While this performance is often drowned out by other exemplary work in the comics portfolio, It's still the centerpiece of a dazzling adventure that captures the absurdity of life and the shattered ego of a depressed radio shock jock. Love, loss, personal downfalls, and a strong cast all come together to prop the Fisher King's reputation up, and it's well deserved.
Oh, didn't she?
You follow her every day, huh?
Oh, it's not like that. I'm deeply smitten.
Who is she? What's her name?
I don't know. A cooler! Oh! Oh, this beautiful needs a little work.
Playing opposite Jeff Bridges, Williams plays the role of Perry, an eccentric, deluded homeless man who saves a radio DJ named Jack from committing suicide before enlisting the man's help in his search for the Holy Grail. Williams' chaotic energy is a perfect match for a director as infamously maniacal as Terry Gilliam. It's a wonder that the film doesn't spin wildly out of control with its mix of fantasy, romance, slapstick, and tragedy, yet it all comes together beautifully. Williams approaches his role in The Fisher King by towing the line between method acting and the rawness of melancholy. When Jack discovers the fateful, heartbreaking connection he shares with Perry, Williams is able to bring an unwavering humanity to a man whose anger and grief are so tangible that they can be plucked out of thin air and held in one's hand. For his efforts, he received his third Oscar nomination and third Golden Globe win.
Nothing on it, how appropriate.
Number 7. Popeye, Popeye. Williams' first leading film role was in this stylized take on the iconic Popeye cartoon, which, if it didn't serve as an early showcase of the comedian's incredible talent, most definitely revitalized the popularity of spinach in the everyday household. Adapted from E.C. Seeger's classic comic strip, the film received mixed reviews at the time of its release due to some of director Robert Altman's questionable creative choices, but has since undergone a critical reappraisal in the years since, with many commending its faithfulness to the source material. Williams' manic performance as the titular Sailor Man may have had something to do with this. Even while buried beneath an emblematic makeup job, Williams brings Popeye's voice and mannerisms to life.
Another thing I got is a sense of humiliation. Now, maybe you swabs can pool your intelligence and sees that I'm asking you for an apology.
He delivers the character's exciting catchphrases on screen while also demonstrating some surprising musical skills during the film's song and dance
Popeye,
numbers.
The sailor, I'm Popeye, the sailor, I'm Popeye, the sailor. I am what I am, and that's all that I am. I am what I am, what I am, what I am. I'm Popeye, the sailor man.
Williams ensures that the perpetual squint and smile of Popeye retains its signature charm, elevating this once-overlooked musical comedy to the point that he imbues the comic strip with a personality of its own. Number 6. Armand Goldman, The Birdcage. It's not often that an American remake of an international hit becomes even more beloved than the original, yet such was the lucky fate of The Birdcage. A surprisingly sly satire on gender politics and right-wing values, Mike Nichols and Elaine May's adaptation of La Cage aux Folles finds Williams as Armand Goldman, the gay owner of a Miami Beach drag club where his partner Albert stars as the headliner. Their lifestyle is comfortable and idyllic, even if their relationship is not.
To change my shoes.
I'll buy you a pair.
I have no pads.
I'll buy you sandals.
Armand! What's going on? Why can't we go home?
But when their son becomes engaged to the daughter of a conservative senator, the two soon face their biggest challenge yet, pretending to be straight. Though Williams plays the more reserved partner, he often relies on his physicality to deliver a brilliant comedic performance. His chemistry with Nathan Lane is on point, and together they create one of the most cherished couples in film history.
Don't use that tone to me.
What tone?
That sarcastic, contemptuous tone that means you know everything because you're a man, and I know nothing because I'm a woman.
You're not a woman.
Oh, you bastard.
Williams will certainly have you laughing, but, given how much the Goldmans champion the importance of being themselves if it means loving one another, he just might have you crying as well.
This is my wife. And this is the lady who had Val.
It's nice to meet you, Catherine.
Very nice, Val. You've done a good job.
Thank you. I'm very proud of him.
The role may have been written to be flamboyant and outgoing, brash perhaps, but the actor exhibits a great deal of control and restraint over how he presents himself. It's an acutely thoughtful speculation on the interpretation of LGBTQIA+ culture, both in life and in the media. Number 5. Daniel Hillard / Mrs. Euphigenia Doubtfire, Mrs. Doubtfire. One of Williams' most commercially successful and instantly recognizable works, Mrs. Doubtfire sees him splitting his screen time between two characters who are quite literally one and the same, and the results are nothing short of side-splitting. In this comedy, he plays Daniel, an out-of-work voice actor determined to spend time with his three kids after he and his wife Miranda decide to separate. With the help of his makeup artist brother, he dons the disguise of Mrs. Doubtfire, an Irish nanny and housekeeper. Hiding in plain sight, he teaches his kids valuable life lessons while learning to become a better father himself. There are many ways in which this performance wouldn't have worked, but Williams goes all in with his embodiment of his stern but good-natured alter ego, so much so that it's sometimes easy to forget that it's him underneath the film's Oscar-winning makeup.
Let's go, kids. Swim time.
Good, dear. I'll be fine.
Come on. Your days are new, Mrs. Doubtfire. Anything you need, just put in my tub, okay?
Thank you, dear. Touch me again, I'll drown you even faster. I'll just sit here and watch you move in on my family.
He dares to push boundaries, both in his physical presence and comedic timing, that had not been reached since Peter Sellers donned a few personalities of his own in Dr. Strangelove. Beneath his clownish exterior, however, Williams just as bravely conveys his character's pain and regret, as Mrs. Doubtfire never shies away from the all-too-real subject of divorce. By the film's heartwarming finale, Williams, in all his frenetic energy, demonstrates the big-heartedness of what Mrs. Doubtfire sets out to embody.
Just because they don't love each other anymore doesn't mean that they don't love you.
Number 4. Sean Maguire, Good Will Hunting. The tragedy of Robin Williams' death gives many of his more dramatic roles an added layer of sadness upon rewatch, but few seem so retroactively devastating as his Oscar-winning turn in Gus Van Sant's Good Will Hunting. Williams plays a therapist who's been asked to help a reclusive genius named Will, played by Matt Damon, and together the two divulge personal secrets, sharing debates over the meaning of life and what to do with the time we have. William's strongest moments are found in scenes where he details the love he still has for his late wife.
My wife used to fart when she was nervous. She had all sorts of wonderful little idiosyncrasies. You know, she used to fart in her sleep. I'm sorry I shared that with you. One night it was so loud it woke the dog up. She woke up and go like, oh, was that you? See, I didn't have the heart to tell. Oh, God.
She woke herself up, yes.
This overwhelmingly caring performance unlocks new dimensions of Williams' abilities and uses loss to unlock an emotional epiphany. Good Will Hunting finds its draw not only through its psychological symmetries, but through Williams' dedication to a role that supports many of the film's most uplifting, poignant, and feel-good moments. True to his nature, Williams is a scene stealer throughout, but his typical outlandishness is replaced with moments of tender subtlety, especially when he delivers one of the greatest monologues of his career.
It's not your fault.
Don't fuck with me, all right? Don't fuck with me, Sean, not you.
It's not your fault.
This film is rowdy, funny, and heartbreaking, but it's also full of life. It wouldn't be so without the addition of Williams to an already impressive ensemble cast. Number 3. The Genie, Aladdin. If it's not the greatest voiceover performance in history, Williams' inspired rendition of the Genie in Aladdin at least set the bar for all subsequent celebrity castings in animated films.
10,000 years will give you such a crick in the neck!
Making a decent case for the role he was born to play, Williams was the perfect choice for this high-energy, fast-talking, pop-culture-referencing wish-granter.
Come on, whisper what it is you want. You ain't never had a friend like me.
Yes, sir, we pride ourselves on service.
You're the boss, the king, the Shah!
Say what you wish, it's yours, true dish, about a little more baklava.
And you could feel the tone of the film change entirely the moment he burst out of his lamp. The role of Genie gave him free rein to do what suited the character best, and thus granted him the ability to recall his stand-up comedy roots in a way that added all the more spunk and flair to this Disney classic.
Patches, what are we trying to say, beggar? No, let's work with me here.
Ooh, I like it muy macho. Now!
The performance earned him an honorary Golden Globe win, and rightfully so, as this role found itself right at home with the actor's imagination. Aladdin is proof of Williams' sheer capability as a performer, and it's astonishing to see how much he's able to accomplish using only his voice. It's also a clear demonstration of his legacy's durability, as the genie has been introducing kids young and old to his effortless wit for close to 30 years. One of the most iconic animated characters of all time, he's also a character that's truly impossible to hate, and given the number of good guys Williams brought to life, that's saying something.
I'm hitting the road. I'm off to see the world.
Number 2. Adrian Cronauer, Good Morning Vietnam.
Good morning Vietnam!
Robin Williams' role in Good Morning Vietnam not only scored him his first Oscar nomination, but also served as a key turning point in the actor's career. In this biographical film, Williams excels as a motor-mouthed radio DJ during the Vietnam War who harnesses the art of unconventional banter through radio broadcast. Following his small-screen success with Mork and Mindy and a series of stand-up tours, Good Morning Vietnam gave Williams the opportunity to fall back into his penchant for ad-libbed humor on a cinematic scale. For being one of the few films to make sense of America's involvement in Vietnam under a comedic lens, it's perfectly understandable that this would be the film to make Williams a superstar in the process. Cronauer's irreverence toward the war, along with Williams' pitch-perfect improvisations within the radio station, are offset by the friendship he develops with two Vietnamese siblings, who expose him to the horrific reality surrounding him. The subject matter is complex and poignant, but the film's structure leaves plenty of breathing room for an untamed form of humor that was seemingly created for Williams and Williams alone. In Letting Loose, he transforms this cautionary wartime comedy into an incredible tour de force. This breakout role helped set the stage for a long string of acclaimed performances from Williams down the line, both comedic and dramatic.
Freddy and the Dreamers!
The wrong speed. We've got it on the wrong speed. For those of you who are recovering from a hangover, that's gonna sound just right.
Let's pull it right back down again. Let's try it a little faster, see if that picks it up a little bit. Let's get up on 718. Those pilots are going right now. I really like the music. I really like the music. I really like the music. Oh, still a bad song.
Hey, wait a minute. Let's try something.
Let's play this backwards and see if it gets any better.
Woof, there's Nev here. Freddy is a devil. Woof, there's Nev here. Freddy is a devil.
Picture a man going on a journey beyond sight and sound. He's left Crete. He's entered the demilitarized zone.
Number 1. John Keating, Dead Poet Society. Robin Williams delivered many unforgettable and emotional performances during his career, but his role as John Keating in Dead Poet Society just might be the one worth remembering the most. As the newly hired English teacher at the all-male Welton Academy, Keating uses his passion for poetry to change the lives of his students.
We don't read and write poetry because it's cute. We read and write poetry because we are members of the human race, and the human race is filled with passion. Medicine, law, business, engineering, these are noble pursuits and necessary to sustain life. But poetry, beauty, romance, love, these are what we stay alive for.
Going against the school's ideologies almost entirely, he encourages the preppy group of young men to think for themselves, oppose conformity, and ultimately seize the day. Keating cares for his students deeply, and Williams' camaraderie with the young ensemble, particularly a young Ethan Hawke, makes for a truly heartwarming experience. While still delivering comedic moments along the way, Williams is at his best and most inspiring when laying bare Keating's love for the arts and the beauty of life. You can't help but be touched when his students hop on their desks and declare their respect for Keating when he is led out of his classroom during the film's emotional finale.
Captain, my captain.
Sit down, Mr. Anderson. You hear me? Sit down. Sit down. This is your final warning, Anderson. How dare you? Do you hear me?
Oh, Captain, my captain.
Miss Nova Street, I warn you. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. All of you.
I want you seated. Sit down. Leave, Mr. Keating.
It's little wonder why Williams earned yet another Oscar nomination for this role. Keating is witty, sincere, and lovable, some of the traits that could very well be used to define Williams himself.
Now, language was developed for one endeavor, and that is, Mr. Anderson, come on, are you a man or an amoeba?
So, those were our picks for Robin Williams' top 10 film performances. It still hurts that Williams is no longer with us, but thankfully, he left behind a rich and varied filmography of bona fide classics for us to remember him by. So what do you think of this list? Comment down below to let us know which of your favorite Robin Williams performances we've left out.